What's up, guys? Greg here with Lens4to-Go and Lens Rentals. Today we're going to be taking a look at the SLR Magic Anamorphot Cine lenses. I'm going to be telling you all about the build of them, some of the features, as well as some of the quirks and the downsides of using these lenses. Pretty much all the things you need to know before you start shooting with them. First, let's take a look at the construction. They have a really nice metal finished housing. There's no plastic on the exterior of these, so they feel really solid. They are just over 5 inches long and weigh in under 2.5 pounds, which is pretty small for an anamorphic style lens like this. That being said, the Micro Four Thirds version is quite a bit bigger than either the PL or EF. The set that I have here is a PL mount, but you can also get it in EF and Micro Four Thirds, and they cover a Super 35 size sensor. Around to the front of the lens, you get an 82 millimeter front filter thread, and this allows you to use variable NDs and other filters because it can be a little bit tricky to use with a matte box, and I'll talk about that a little bit later. For features, these lenses are kind of lacking in that area. There isn't really anything that makes them stand out from other lenses. One of the things that is a little bit different with these ones though is that there's two different squeeze factors. So for the EF and PL mounts, you get a 1.33 times squeeze factor, and for the Micro Four Thirds mount, you get a 2x squeeze factor. The other thing that's pretty interesting and why you'd actually pick up an anamorphic lens like this is for the unique characteristics of the optics and how they flare and the bokeh, and these definitely have some unique look to them. I did a lens test testing each of the focal lengths so you can see how those actually handle in different situations. I'll throw a link to all of them in the description below if you want to go check them out and see more about how they perform optically. Now, these lenses being at the price point that they are and trying to offer what they say they do, they definitely have some of the quirks that come along with that price point. The first one being the minimum focus distance of 3.5 feet, which applies to all of the lenses in the set. And this can make it tricky to get product shots or close-up shots, even at the 70 millimeter focal length. Also talking about the focus, when you rotate the focus ring, it actually rotates the front element, so if there's any dust or dirt on it, you can actually see that if you're closed down, you can see a dot moving through the frame. The other thing is it actually telescopes the lens, so that's why using a matte box can be difficult, as well as using a follow focus, because the lens barrel telescopes in and out as you rack focus. Another thing with pulling focus is that the only focus mark that's on this lens is right on the top of it, so if you have your camera up high and you can only see the side of the lens, you're not going to be able to pull focus accurately without using a monitor. There are three more quirks about this lens, but they deal more with the optical quality rather than the build and usability like we've been talking about. And the first one is the distortion. At 35 millimeters, there's a crazy amount of distortion and it almost looks like a fisheye lens. Even on the 50 millimeter, there's a little bit of bowing and edge distortion on the sides. Definitely go and check out the lens test if you want to see that more in detail and see me walk through all of that. Next thing is the sharpness of these lenses. Now, they're not too sharp wide open. You can get them sharper by stopping down about a full stop, but that means you need a lot more light, especially with the 70 millimeter being a T4. That means you need to stop down to about a 5.6 to get that lens sharp, which means you need a ton of light, and that can be pretty difficult in low budget or running gun style shoots. And lastly, but this only applies to the Micro Four Thirds version of the lens, and that's if you're using a GH5 with in-body stabilization. When you're panning back and forth, you do get some pretty hard vignetting on the corners, so beware of that, especially when you're using the 35 millimeter lens. So there you go, there are some things to know about the SLR Magic Anamorphot Cine lenses. Hopefully this helped you out and gave you a little better idea of what to expect when you're using these lenses. If you guys want to try this lens out for yourself, I'll throw a card to it right up there, as well as some links in the description. If you guys enjoyed this video and want to see more anamorphic lenses on the channel, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe for new videos every week, and I'll see you in the next one.